Okay. Hi, you two.
What's poppin' YouTube? This is your girl Shivani and welcome back to my channel. There's a change in the backdrop because you know, today we are doing a living room plants tour and I'm so hyped about it. Like legit, I don't have a lot of plants, but believe me guys, these plants have given me so much joy and so much content over the past year. So because of COVID and the situation that we are all in, I have been inside my house, like indoors, the entire 2020 you can say, and I'm so glad that I had these beautiful plants to give me company. Every morning when I wake up and come down and have a look at these plants, they make me so happy. There's sort of like a ray of hope that things are gonna get better very soon. These beautiful plants have been thriving and they are growing so beautifully, and I'm so excited to give you a tour of my living room plants in today's video. Before we get started with the video, do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you would like to watch more such videos. I mean, I know this is a little different from what I've been doing on my channel usually, but trust me guys, this is what you have asked me to do, right? We will be focusing on not only sneakers and street style going forward, we'll be doing lot more than that, so I'm hopeful that you are hyped up about that as well. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and also click on the bell notifications icon so that you do not miss out on any of my videos going forward. Also guys, I'm wearing these beautiful, really cute tie-dye Crocs. You know, I'm a big fan of tie-dye, so this is actually a get well soon gift from my boyfriend, and I'm filming a lookbook in these Crocs very soon, which I believe will be uploaded next. So yeah, stay tuned for that. Now let's start my living room plants tour video. Let's go. In this video, I'll not only give you guys a tour of all the living room plants that I currently have, along with that, I'll also tell you how do I take care of them and also about their watering requirements and the sunlight requirements, etc., etc. So that if you guys are planning to keep or buy a few new indoor plants, I hope this video is also helpful for you in that way. So let's start with this beautiful plant. This right here is a Syngonium white butterfly plant, if I'm not wrong. This is actually one of the first plants that I got. I think I got it from the Chhatarpur nursery, but this plant has like tripled in size. You know, how cool about that? So this plant requires indirect sunlight, which is why I've kept it behind my mirror. And also guys, I've been really wanting to have a basketball planter. I have not been able to cut this basketball into two and put a plant inside. I'm gonna legit make it into a planter, but for now I've kept the pot behind the mirror and this basketball here. You know, this pretty much gives you an illusion of a basketball planter. Like this looks like that this plant is coming out of this basketball. This plant needs minimum maintenance and it's perfect to keep indoors, and you can water it 2 to 3 times a week. This was like a tiny plant when I got it first, and this has been thriving so beautifully. I love this plant. Okay, so next we have my beautiful Erica palm, the very popular Erica palm that you must have seen in a lot of house tour videos. Also, she has literally doubled its size. Unfortunately, I don't have a picture of when I bought her. She is thriving beautifully and it's such a pleasure to look at her. So I have pretty much kept big plants here in front of the mirrors. This is where I also take a lot of my Instagram pictures. She doesn't need a lot of maintenance, not a lot of sunlight, so I also keep moving her. You can never water her a lot, you know, she'll literally die. Depending upon winters or summers, I water her like 2-3 times a week. But again guys, you need to keep a look at the soil. If the soil has completely become dry, that is when you need to water. I also try to, you know, hydrate them like thrice a week. And coming to the next one here, she is the snake plant. I'm sure you have seen the snake plant also. She is one of the very popular indoor plants. You guys cannot talk about it anywhere else, okay? So I stole her from Deer Park, and I went jogging to Deer Park, and then she was just, you know, lying on the ground, and I was like, no, I cannot let a beautiful plant die. And I carried it home and I planted it. So she was literally 5 leaves, and look at how beautiful she looks right now. The next one here, guys, she is the philodendron. She hasn't been growing a lot. She only grew like 2 new leaves. So this one and the one right here behind, these are new leaves. Maintenance wise, I have put fertilizer. I water her twice a week. I also hydrate her like 4 times a week. Looks like a new leaf is coming out, but this has been the situation for like the past 2 or 3 months. I'm hyped to see how beautifully it's gonna thrive, so yeah. If you're wondering about these beautiful planters, these are stainless steel planters that I've bought from IKEA. You can buy these planters and also a couple other things that you like from IKEA from Amazon. Basically, people buy from IKEA and they list it out on Amazon, although it's a little higher in price, but I really like them. They go beautifully with the tone and the vibe of my house. Very minimal, sort of grayish and whitish. And yeah, a lot of people also want me to film my house tour video. Unfortunately, I am not done decorating my beautiful house. So guys, that's gonna take a while, but for now, enjoy my living room plants tour. Moving on to this corner, I'm sure you guys have seen this corner a lot of times. This is where I film. So this right here, I have this Ficus lyrata, also very popularly known as the fiddle leaf fig. And this plant is the most expensive plant in my plants collection. So this costed me around, what, $3,000? Yeah, and the pot was separate. I've always wanted to have a fiddle leaf in my living room, and I'm really happy that this beautiful plant got a perfect spot right here in the corner. So I have kept it next to the window because this plant needs sufficient sunlight. Watering is 2 to 3 times a week, depending upon how soon and how early the soil becomes dry. So guys, you always need to be careful while watering the plants. You need to check if the soil has dried off completely. Only then you should water the plant. And when you water, you should water till the brim of the pot. But this particular plant is a tropical plant, which is why this needs to be hydrated properly. Although this plant has only grown 2 leaves as of now, but you know, for a very long time it didn't grow any new leaves, and I was really worried. She makes me so happy. I really love her. So right next to my fiddle leaf fig, I have my aloe vera plant. And if you guys are wondering about the pots, I bought these pots along with my fiddle leaf from one of the nurseries in Delhi. So these are ceramic planters and white that goes beautifully with the whole tone of my living room. So this aloe vera plant, actually I brought her from my hometown, like Assam. I have planted her only in cocopeat, so this is purely cocopeat. There's no soil, which is why I feel the growth is a little slow, but this is a new leaf, and I'm really happy that she's been thriving. Aloe vera is really good for your skin, and it doesn't need a lot of maintenance. Ideally, you should have an aloe vera so that you can take care of your skin, you know? Next, I have my money plant, or the pothos, which also is a very popular living room plant. This, guys, there's a story. I have stolen it from my neighbor. Just stole one small, like, you know, one leaf, that's all. But I have propagated it. I actually propagated 3 plants out of the same, you know, one leaf that I stole from my neighbor. And believe me or not, this is how beautiful she looks right now. She's like really long. This is how long she has grown so far. And you can see there are new leaves coming out. This also doesn't need a lot of maintenance. I just water her like 2 times a week. What I also do for all my plants is I use a microfiber cloth or like a clean towel. And once I hydrate them, once I mist all the leaves, I also wipe it out so that, you know, all the dust and all of that goes out of the leaf so that it looks prettier. And of course, the moisture actually reaches the leaf properly. Is one of the plants that I can say I'm so proud of propagating. This has been my successful propagation. And the one next to it is just a snake plant that I've propagated. It's so easy to propagate a snake plant. I tell you guys, cut a leaf and you need to put it in water for like what, 3 to 4 days. And the 5th day or 6th day onwards, the leaf itself starts to grow roots on it. In this corner, I have my dumb cane. So guys, I'm a little confused if this beautiful plant is a dumb cane or an aglaonema. The problem is I bought her from the hawker downstairs. You know, there's this guy who comes with a lot of plants and the pots and all of that, right? They don't always know the correct name, and I completely forgot what he told me when I bought her. But yeah, if you guys happen to know what this plant is called, please leave a comment down below. I would love to know that from you. She has also been thriving, guys. This is a new leaf, and there's a new leaf right here. I water her like 3 times a week, spray good amount of water on all the leaves. One needs indirect sunlight, which is why I've kept it in this corner. Here I have one of my favorite plants, the very popular Monstera. So this also I have bought her from the same nursery that I got the fiddle leaf and the pots. So when I got her, she only had like 3 leaves. One of the leaves was this plain leaf. That leaf didn't have these holes. I was not sure if that's a legit Monstera. I got her anyway. This you can see that because of the color, this is a new plant. This is also a new plant, by the way. Either this or this is also a new plant. As per the watering requirement goes, she needs water 2 to 3 times a week. It needs less sunlight actually. So this corner doesn't get a lot of sunlight. This is a little farther from the window. This is a corner which I have set up. I have kept her on top of this wooden box. This is a PR box actually. And then I also have my basketballs here. She's also next to my sneaker collection, which I'm also gonna film very soon for you guys. So guys, here I have the 2 last plants in my living room, although I'm not sure if this staircase is a part of the living room. This basically goes from the living room to my bedroom, but I didn't want to leave these 2 beautiful plants behind. I have propagated both of them. This one is a snake plant, as you can see. This has got 2 leaves, and again, the growth is a little slow in cocoapeat. If you guys have also faced the same, please let me know in the comments down below so that I can improve the growth of all the plants that I've grown in cocoapeat alone and no soil. I know for a fact, you know, after looking at the growth of my snake plant, this is definitely gonna thrive. This is a money plant, and you see these corners have been bitten off by a squirrel. Usually I also keep my plants like once a week outdoors in my balcony. This one has not been growing for so long and I was really worried, but this new beautiful life coming out, and this is just exciting for me. My plan for the staircase is to have lots of plants and all the, you know, stairs. So I want to have like climbers so that when I look at the staircase from a little far, you know, it's gonna excite me. I don't have a lot of space right now for big plants, just like that of the Monstera or the Erica palm or the fiddle leaf, but I for sure want to have a rubber plant in my house. Terrariums on my coffee table, I mean, that's what I'm thinking of right now. I want to have anthurium, pink or the red anthurium. I want to have a lot of ferns. I want to also have that, I don't know what is it called exactly, but there's a spurl plant, you know, and I really like it. That is all I had in this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed checking out all my living room plants. Also gave you a little bit of detail about how do I take care of those plants. So if you happen to buy these plants, I'm sure this video is gonna be helpful for you. And until next time, I shall see you very soon. Bye.